Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Daisy and today we are going to be reacting to the video. Oh, I am going to react to the video and we're going to watch it together. So the video is about a wedding vow that was in spoken words and a bride surprise that was burned with it. And I'm going to be reacting to the video. This is like going to be the first of its kind. So I want you to do this like, okay. So, what's going to be happening is I'm going to be watching the video and I'll be giving my reaction to it. I haven't watched the video. I wanted to start and I was like, okay, let's just do this on camera. So, we're going to watch the video together. Let's go. Alright.
You may now kiss the bride.
We're gonna do it slightly different today. I've got something to say.
After the shakara, we was the kiss.
We didn't make it this far because of luck. Luck suggests success or failure, apparently brought by chance rather than through one's own actions. This can't be luck. Because this relationship was built on a bed of decisions, and if Christ is the pillow, a headrest, then let us never forget to adjust our pillows whenever we get tired of getting at each other's necks. I can't put this down to luck. It's too divine to call it a coincidence. But neither do I subscribe to the idea of a soulmate. We provoke a love in each other so deep, it makes you dig from the top of your crown to the bottom of your souls. Mate, what a journey this has been. In our darkest times, we had to push. We had to dig. And when your shove broke, you borrowed mine. Sometimes I would use that same shove to hit you. I asked myself how it was possible to harm someone I love so much. My weakest moments taught me that I can only love you because the Holy Spirit enables me to. That my flesh is incapable of loving patiently, of loving selflessly, of loving kindly. Our weakest moments taught us this. Remember when we were going through the roughest patch of our lives? I told you the following. If you are feeling weary, lay your head on my lap. If you are scared, resist fear with everything that Christ has instilled in you. If you are depressed, laugh as if you were not aware of your plight. Fight even when you feel you have no more fight, and when you are fatigued, baby, fight some more. You are my best friend. I know when you are elated, your accent travels from Nigeria through to England and then back to Russia. You make me laugh effortlessly. I know when you're tense, your jaw clenches, and I promise that I would use my hands as a tool to help you unwind. I know when you're nervous, you don't talk much. You just stare and move in a manner that's quite distinctive, but only I can recognize it. Do you remember when I told you this? You see, I didn't want to write a poem, you know, because I know as a spoken word artist, this is expected of me, and you know I hate cliches. Nevertheless, I promised myself if I did write a poem, I would show both sides of Christ-centered love. I hope I have shown that Christ-like love is not easy. It is not glamorous. But it is worth it. Now, can I tell you why I have married you? You're beautiful. Sorry if I ever contended if you were head. It's just that I had confused leadership for dictatorship. Thank you for never having a fragile sense of masculinity. But most importantly, thank you for changing my mind on what it should look like. You see, it's not your arms that make you a man, even though they're kind of nice still. It's your ability to always accept when you're wrong, even though the world tells you your ego is all you have. It's your willingness to fall to your knees in worship. But for you, it's not just the posture. Your actions and your heart are aligned. It's your ability to demand respect without being uncouth or disrespectful. even though the world told you your ego is all you have, even though the world told you to live by your fists, you live by the word. It told you to make peace with all men, and you do. It's your ability to forgive me in advance. You know I am prone to error, and you do not hold this against me. Mrs. Jarinatu was an amazing woman. I know this because of your siblings. I know this because of her son. I know this because of the man that you have become. And I love the man that you have become. Thank you for always choosing to love me. I pray that I will always do the same in Jesus' name.
Oh, that was amazing. That was beautiful. Let me take a minute. It was just amazing to see people expressing love in a beautiful form. It was. I'm speechless, to be honest. It was good. It was. Thing is, I've always wanted to do a reaction video for Vows. So my dad sent me this, and I was like, oh, let me just watch it. So I was like, I opened it, sent me the link, and I opened it, and I saw that, it was most likely going to be a vow. And so I watched, like, I think the first 3 to 3 seconds, so to confirm. So when I saw her talking, and I was like, okay, let's see what this has, let's watch this on camera. I'm going to look for a couple and do more so reaction videos. Videos for people about the weddings, hashtags, everything I see on an hashtag. Lots and lots of reaction videos. It is the first of many. But this was beautiful. I do not know that. I think they have a YouTube channel. Yeah, they have a YouTube channel. I checked, and it was really amazing. So thank you guys for watching. Remember to subscribe to my YouTube channel and follow me. Follow me on Instagram and on Twitter. A Daisy. Thank you. Live, love, and laugh.